It's an earthquake! At least we're in an earthquake-resistant building. Thanks, science! DNews is based in grand old San Francisco, known for its culture or counterculture, giant reddish-orange bridge, and earthquakes. Earthquakes happen when tectonic plates shift. The sudden burst of energy sends seismic waves shooting in all directions. These waves can violently shake buildings both up and down and side to side with enormous force. It's this forceful shifting that actually causes stress on buildings, sometimes to the point of collapse. As we live in an earthquake-prone area, we realize a fundamental truth. Earthquakes don't kill people. Buildings do. So researchers have spent a lot of time wondering how to make buildings safer. When an engineer is first planning a new building, they have to take into account where a building will be built. Earthquake guidelines are different in, say, Kansas than in California. The intensity of forces from earthquakes varies from place to place. The goal when building in high-intensity earthquake areas is to make a building earthquake-resistant. Earthquake-proof is doable, but extremely expensive. Now, to be considered earthquake-resistant, a building can suffer damage, but it can't collapse on the people trying to get out. And there's two main ways to do that, by designing a building so it's stronger or more flexible. One way engineers can make buildings stronger is by reinforcing concrete with steel. But in high-risk areas like California, that's often not enough. One of the most effective ways to protect a building from such disasters is to keep them from moving by detaching it from the ground. Base isolation is when engineers design a structure to be built on top of a separate base instead of attached to a foundation, so that when an earthquake hits, the base moves, but the building only sways slightly. For instance, San Francisco's City Hall was retrofitted with a base isolation system. And this concept isn't new. We see these examples as early as the 4th century. They utilized isolation bases made of smooth rocks that could slide against each other. In modern times, these bases are usually made out of a combination of a flexible material like rubber and steel. The rubber also acts like a shock absorber. But a cool piece of shocking tech comes from Taiwan. The super tall skyscraper Taipei 101 combats earthquakes with a giant 728-ton ball. Well, it's technically called a tuned mass damper, but it's basically a giant ball that's suspended near the top of the building. If the building sways because of an earthquake or typhoon, the damper swings in the opposite direction. During a particularly strong gust in 2015, the ball in Taipei 101 swung a meter from its center position. And technology is getting even more advanced. According to one study published in the journal Applied Physics Letters, researchers are working on a way to make a building invisible to shockwaves using a shield. The shield of concrete and plastic is buried at least 3 feet down, looks like two rainbows surrounding the building with a gap between them. Each strip or color is more stiff the farther out they are from the core. The waves have an easier time traveling through a stiff and hard layer, so the waves, once they hit a softer layer, deflect and head back to the easier path. The way these plates curve essentially channels the shockwaves around the building. As they move around the building, they hit a gap in the plate, which allows some of the force to dissipate. So the plate kind of hides the building from an earthquake, like an invisibility cloak for earthquakes. When earthquakes hit, their intensity is measured in a point system called the Richter Scale. Trace takes a look at the different ways seismologists measure earthquakes and what these ratings mean in this episode right here.
When rocks are sliding, knocking, and buffeting against one another, they can slip, crack, jerk, and cause an earthquake. But the friction and the fault line, the pressure, the depth, the type of rock, and the varied stressors of that rock's history all matter. To turn that into one number is actually a pretty crazy idea if you think about it.
Have you lived through an earthquake? Tell me your experience down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews so you don't miss a single episode.